Welcome to the ThinkCell tutorials. This video is the second of two videos on annotating and decorating your ThinkCell charts. It will cover axes, scales, and breaks. Let's say you would like to insert a y-axis to your stacked chart. Right-click onto the chart and select Add Y-axis from the context menu. The axis is added to the left of your chart. ThinkCell automatically scales the value axis according to the size and values of your chart, and keeps it up to date when your data changes. To manually scale a value axis, select it with your mouse and drag one of the handles at either end. Release when you're happy with the extension of the scale. The values on the axis must always include the range between the lowest and highest values in the chart. Holding down Alt while dragging allows you to end the axis between tick marks. To restore automatic scaling, drag the handle until the tooltip reads Automatic and release. As with scaling, ThinkCell also automatically calculates the tick mark spacing. To manually change it, select the axis and drag the small handle at the first tick mark. The handle will snap to suggested tick mark spacing options indicated by a tooltip. If you would like to have even finer control over the spacing, hold down Alt while dragging. Release when you are satisfied with the new value for the tick mark spacing. To revert to automatic spacing, reduce the spacing with the handle until the tooltip reads Automatic and release. By default, a y-axis is positioned to the left of a chart. You can, however, change this position by simply clicking on the axis and dragging it to the other side of the chart. Release to place it there. In a line chart, you get two different positioning options for the y-axis on each side. If you do not want the data points of the first category to be placed directly on the y-axis, you can drag the y-axis to the left to leave a small gap between it and the first category. When you right-click on a value axis, a context menu will offer a variety of options to edit the axis. You can, for instance, add or delete an axis title, tick mark labels, tick marks, or grid lines. If appropriate, you may also toggle between a logarithmic and linear scale axis. Let's assume you have a chart like this, with particularly large segments alongside much smaller ones. To enhance the readability of the smaller segments, you can add a value axis break. Right-click on the part of the segment or axis where you want to insert the break. This will open the context menu. When adding a value axis break, the exact position you right-click onto a segment or axis makes a difference. Select Add Break to insert the break at the chosen position. Adding a value axis break is not possible if there's not enough space in the chart to fit the break shape between segment borders in any of the chart's columns, as the break applies to all segments sharing the same range of the axis. When you have added a break, you may adjust its extent. Click on the break once to select it, then drag one of the handles up or down to change the extent of the break, and release. You can also change the style of the breaks. Right-click on the break and select Set Wiggle Shape from the context menu to switch the straight break into a wiggle. Vice versa, click on Set Straight Shape to turn a wiggle into a straight break. To hide or show the break's outline, left-click on the break and pick your preferred option from the floating toolbar. To delete a break, just select it and hit the Delete key. Now let's turn to a special type of x-axis, the date axis. Assume that the category row of your data sheet contains strictly increasing year numbers. Left-click into a category label and pick a date format from the control box in the floating toolbar. When you format the labels of your x-axis as dates, as in this case, the axis turns into a date axis. The same occurs when Excel's cell format is set to date for all category cells and the category label format in your chart is set to use Excel format. One advantage of using a date axis is that when you scale it, years, months, and weeks can be used for tick mark spacing. Mix 2- and 4-digit year numbers on a date axis by left-clicking on one of the middle labels and picking YY from the label format control box. The inner labels change to 2-digit format, while the outer labels keep their 4-digit format. Let's say you have two similar charts on the same slide, and you would like them to share the same scale for the y-axis. In this case, both charts have the same height, although the waterfall chart on the right represents only 20 units, whereas the stack chart on the left represents 47 units. To make two or more charts visually comparable, first multi-select the charts by holding Shift and clicking on them. Then right-click into the selection and pick Set Same Scale from the context menu. The scale of the chart with the smaller values is resized to match the larger one. The same scale connection between the charts is maintained even if you change the data. If one of the charts is rescaled due to changed data, the scales of all other charts set to the same scale are adjusted as well, including when axis breaks are added or resized. If you want to revert Set Same Scale, right-click into one or a multi-selection of charts and choose Fit Scale to Data from the context menu. Line charts and combination charts may have a secondary y-axis with a separate scaling. If it is not already there, insert a second y-axis by right-clicking on the chart and picking Add Second Y-Axis. You can define which line or column should be associated with which y-axis. Right-click on a line or column and select Set to Right Axis. The scaling of the respective axis is automatically adapted if necessary. To delete an axis, just select it and hit the Delete key. Now let's turn back to the category axis and look at the spacing between columns. Basic spacing is determined by the column width and the chart size. When you have a chart like this and decide you would like to have extra spacing between, for example, the second and third column, you can insert a category gap. Click on the baseline between two columns at the point where you want the category gap to be, then click on the drag handle, hold down the mouse button, and drag to the right. While you drag, the handle snaps to every full category gap, and a tooltip shows how many gaps you will insert. A category gap is as wide as one column width plus one gap width. When you insert a category gap, the width of the column is preserved while the overall chart width changes. If you'd like to keep the overall chart width, hold down Control while dragging. The column widths will be increased or decreased to make up for the category gap. If you would like to indicate a break in the continuity of the category axis scale, for instance, because your data has a gap for certain years, just right-click onto the category axis between two columns and select Add Baseline Break from the context menu. A break shape is inserted into the baseline. If you want to delete it, just select it and hit the Delete key. That's it for this video and the two-part series on chart annotations and decorations. Thanks for watching. If you haven't already done so, we recommend watching the first part of this series on arrows, lines, connectors, and legends, or visit our website for more ThinkCell tutorials.